Well, I think it's an inherent human characteristic to want to know where we come from. Astronomy answers the bigger picture, the ultimate question: where is our place in the universe?
I think astronomers would like to think that we're really gaining a lot of understanding about our universe, but really only understand about 5%.
The galaxy is a very dusty place, and this inhibits our ability to see clearly across the galaxy when we use normal optical light. What we have done is we've actually taken advantage of the fact that the dust does not block infrared light. So Apogee is exploring the galaxy at infrared wavelengths, wavelengths that are longer than our eyes can actually detect.
The Apogee instrument itself receives the light that is garnered at the back end of very wide field telescopes. The light comes into our instrument and it's divided by wavelength, if you will.
And then we use fiber optic cables to channel the starlight into Apogee, from which we can analyze the chemical properties of the star and how it's moving. In the northern hemisphere, we only get half a view of our galaxy, so we've built a twin instrument for a telescope in Chile. So while the University of Virginia led the project and we integrated the instrument here, it required the collaboration of scientists and engineers from across the world. What Apogee is allowing us to do for the first time is make a comprehensive map of our galaxy all the way from one edge to the other.
But I'm hoping that with Apogee, with all of this data that we're coming up with, some of the most important things that is discovered is stuff that we haven't anticipated.
Where is the most likely place that we can form planets that could harbor life? How do the chemical properties of the stars impact the formation of planets around them? So these are very big questions, and I think Apogee has a long career ahead of it getting to those kinds of questions.